everybody. I'm here today to tell you how to tell when your car needs new brakes. In this video, I'll be going over 5 warning signs that your car needs new brake pads. Now, let's get right to it. Warning sign number one, the first thing that will allow you to know whether or not your car needs new brake pads is a visual inspection. Now, that literally means getting down and looking at the thickness of the brake pad. Now, if you go and look at the braking assembly and the components of the brake assembly, you'll be able to actually see the brake pad pressing up against the rotor. Now, your brake pad starts out being quite thick, and then what happens is as you use it and it wears down, it gets thinner and thinner and thinner. Now, when you look at the brake pad being pressed up against the brake rotor, you should see at least 1/4 inch of thickness of the brake pad. If you see less than 1/4 inch, then it's time to consider replacing your brake pads soon. So just the first warning sign is a visual inspection. Just actually look at the brake pad itself and see how thick it is. If it's thick enough, more than 1/4 inch thick, then you should be good to go for at least a little while. If it's less than 1/4 inch thick, then you should really consider looking into the idea of getting new brake pads. The second warning sign that you might need or will likely need new brake pads is to listen for a screeching sound. Now, you see, inside of your braking assembly, there's a little piece of metal. And what happens is when your brakes wear down, that metal touches the brake rotor. So when you press the brakes, you hear a screeching sound, sort of like an annoying screeching sound, for lack of better terms. And that is there on purpose. It's not there by accident. That little piece of metal, that little indicator, is there to allow you to know through listening that your brake pads are worn down and that you need new ones soon. It's sort of telling you through sound that it's the end of the life of those brake pads, okay? The third warning sign that you should look for that will allow you to know that you need new brake pads is less braking power. So when you get new brakes, you'll notice this. The moment that you get new brake pads and you're going from, you know, old brake pads to new brake pads, all of a sudden your car feels like a sports car. It can brake so effectively, so quickly, so aggressively. You'll notice that you'll be used to pushing the brake pedal down this much and you're gonna be flying forward because your car brakes so hard. And that's because as your brake pads get older, they lose braking power. They lose their effectiveness, okay? Brake pads are sort of meant to do that. They're meant to work best when they're brand new, just like everything else, right? You get a computer, it works best when it's brand new, and then it sort of slowly fades with its performance. The same thing happens with so many things in life. You know, you get new windshield wipers and they work best when they're brand new, and then slowly their performance fades. They start leaving streaks, they start leaving spots, and so forth. Brakes are no different. Brake pads are no different. They're gonna be the best when they're brand new, and then they're gonna slowly lose their effectiveness. So if you notice that you have to press that brake pedal down significantly harder than you had to when you first got the brakes, then chances are you should look into getting new brake pads. There are a few other things that can cause it, but if you're seeing a few of these warning signs together, then chances are you should look into getting new brake pads, okay? Warning sign number 4 is the car pulling to one side or the other when you press the brakes. Now, brakes theoretically should wear evenly. They should wear at the same rate, you know, the brake pads on both sides. But that's in theory. In practice, brake pads tend to wear, you know, more towards one side or the other, meaning your left brake pad might wear faster than your right one, or vice versa. Now, for that reason, you know, as the brake pads wear unevenly, when you press the brakes, your car might be pulling to one side or the other. Now, like I said, there are some other things that can cause this too, but if you're noticing multiple of these signs together, then that's definitely something to look into. Last but not least, the 5th warning sign that should allow you to know whether or not you need new brake pads is a grinding sound. Now, There are, like I said, a few things that can cause a grinding sound, but if you hear a grinding sound when you press the brakes, it might be the case that you actually wore down your brake pads completely. And that's actually, that means that you've gone past these other warning signs, you've worn down your brake pads completely, and you're gonna be affecting your rotors. So if you continue driving with that grinding sound, and it's because you wore down your brake pads completely, then you might need new brake pads and new rotors because you're gonna be grinding away at the rotors, okay? And you know, you're gonna be paying a lot more money for brake pads and rotors as opposed to just brake pads. And that's basically it. In this video, I have gone over how to tell when your car needs new brakes. I've gone over specifically 5 warning signs. Now, you should be looking for a few of these warning signs together, and that will allow you to look into it further. And you know, you can use the idea of maybe getting new brake pads as a possibility. Now, if you see a few of these warning signs together, look into your brake pads themselves. Either you can look into them yourself or get a professional or a mechanic to look into them. And you know, you can sort of play with the idea of getting new brake pads or look into it in the near future. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. What are some other warning signs that you know of that will allow you to know that you need new brake pads? Let me know down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.